What's going on, guys? This is Joe. If you are here following the first video, welcome to the second video in our Hunt for Jace series. If you were not here for the first one, no, Jace is not missing in the story, at least as of the time of this recording. If it works out that way, that'd be kind of funny, but I personally am missing the Jace from Magic Origins. I never opened him in all the tons of Magic Origins product that we opened on our channel. I never got a Jace, and I was super unhappy about it. So I picked up a bunch of blisters. I want to open them up, and I want to see if I get a Jace. It is nice to reminisce about Magic Origins a little bit. I know it hasn't been that long, but we're going to give it a try. We have six blisters, as you can see, to open in this video. If we get a Jace in the first pack or something, that's fine. We can still hunt for a foil one or more than one. So fear not, but we're going to get started. Let me zoom in, make sure everybody can see what we're working with here. We found it in the last video that just because there's one of the Planeswalkers on the outside does not mean that the pack on the inside has those Planeswalkers. So Jace was on the outside. Kytheon slash Gideon is on the inside. So as I said, no guarantees on it being the same. In fact, I don't know that we've seen one that's been the same yet. So we shall see what we get out of these packs. Zoom in a little bit more. There we go. So we start with Healing Hands. Awesome card, which I'm not stupid. I'm kidding. This is not an awesome card. Dead Bridge Shaman. Vastwood Gorger. Disperse. Suppression Bonds. This was a sweet card. Veteran Sidearm, Titan Strength, Read the Bones, classic. We have a Calculated Dismissal, a Seismic Elemental is our first uncommon, Hydro Lash is our second, and Zendikar's Royal is our third, referencing the next plane that we would go to after Magic Origins. Behind that, our rare or mythic is an Abbot of Carol Keep. This card is not bad. Not bad at all. I am not too upset seeing it. Clearly, it's not Jace, but still, if we're not going to be opening Jace, this is not a bad substitute. There is something else back here. Is it a flip Planeswalker, or is it a foil? It is a foil. It is a foil common in Stalwart Aven. It's an okay foiling pattern. Nothing super special. It's kind of armor on its chest plate looks nice, and the background does, but it being its wings and its, you know, feathers, etc., are not in foil, so it doesn't look as good as it could, but it's a foil. So there you go. In the Stalwart Aven, we have a swamp and an add card, because we're going to get tons of those, because that's what they do or did in older sets, is give you tons of add cards. Here is a Liliana blister, as you can see. Let's see what the pack is inside this Liliana blister, if I can ever rip it open. Apparently, I have no muscles. Oh, there we go. Okay. Wow, first time. Liliana inside of a Liliana blister. Fascinating. It only took us, what, 8 packs to get there? Let's see what we have inside. Maybe that's a good sign. Fingers crossed, everyone. Thornbow Archer. Cobble Brute. Enshrouding Mist. Weight of the Underworld. Elvish Visionary. Nivix Barrier. Mantle of Webs. We have a Boggart Brute, Alchemist's Vial, Unholy Hunger. This was such a cool piece of art depicting the zombies kind of killing that angel so Liliana could get her iconic headdress. Just awesome. Whirler Rogue. This card was fantastic and one of the first things that we saw from Kaladesh, which now it's kind of old hat for us, but there you go. And it's our first uncommon. Totem Guide Heartbeast. And Blightcaster, and our rare or mythic. First of all, look at how cool the colors in that art are. Anyway, our rare or mythic in this pack is another Molten Vortex. I say another because we got one in the last video. Again, it was probably linked at the top, but otherwise I'll link it at the top. You guys should definitely go check that out to see what you missed. But here's a Molten Vortex. We have an island behind that with some kind of cool island art. I like that. Which looks like it's on Vryn, I would assume. Which just makes sense for Jace, and a soldier token. So yeah, give us, you know, other things from Vryn, like, I don't know, maybe Jace. Here's a Chandra blister, which inside of it we have, once I can rip, there we go. I want to, like, destroy the pack inside. Kytheon slash Gideon. We have, in this pack, a Touch of Moonglove. Act of Treason, Titanic Growth, Disperse, love that Disperse art, talked about that before. Nissa's Pilgrimage, Enlightened Ascetic, Gearpour Gearcrafter, more Kaladesh. We have a Rabid Bloodsucker, a Separatist Void Mage, pretty impactful card. We have a Murder Investigation as our first uncommon. A Goblin Glory Chaser as our second. This guy's pretty sweet. And a Bounding Krasis as our third, speaking of pretty sweet. And it's a gold uncommon for us, which are not that common to see. No pun intended, I guess. Our rare or mythic behind that is an Avaricious Dragon. So here is a mythic. Not quite the one we were looking for, not quite super valuable, but the art is fantastic. I love that. It's our second kind of noteworthy red rare or mythic. And there was a foil back there. It was part green. I don't know if you guys saw that, but we'll see what it is. Behind the Avaricious Dragon, we have a foil common in Yiva's Force Mage. And actually, not too bad of a foiling pattern. I like it. The background looks cool. The top of the staff looks really cool. So there's that, plus the stuff like dangling off of the robe or the sleeve looks nice. So there you go, a pretty sweet foiling pattern on a common. Behind that, a forest and a Thopter token. We've been seeing a lot more of those recently. Hey look, a Jace blister. Fingers crossed, we're trying, guys. We're getting there. This is gonna be a very poorly named series if we don't get a Jace, but at the same time, it's still kind of fun. Here's a Nissa pack. These seem to be a little rarer to find. I haven't seen any Nissa packs, I haven't seen a lot of Nissa packs. Again, maybe that's a good sign, or maybe I'm just lying to myself to make myself feel better. We have Smash to Smithereens, Amperin Tactician, Fetid Imp, Might of the Masses, Water Courser, Read the Bones. We have a Calculated Dismissal, a Llanowar Empath, I like this guy a lot, an Enlightened Ascetic, a Fire Fiend Elemental, a Sigil of Valor for our first uncommon, a Meteorite, and an Anchor to the Aether. And I think I mentioned this in the last video. It's Aether, not Ether in this card. In Kaladesh, it is Aether. Long story if you're not aware. Anyway, behind that we have... I complained about the series not being an apt name, and here we go, boys and girls. This is Jace Varin's Prodigy, everyone. He flips into Jace, Telepath Unbound. I am lucky. I really didn't expect to get him. I'm super happy to have gotten him, because why else would I have made the series? But come on, that's awesome. That's so cool. All right, cool. Jace Varin's Prodigy, guys. There he is. Like I said, I got two more packs to open, and I'm still opening them just because I got this Jace. We'll see what else might be in this pack. The little token card for them and the I don't care. So we'll leave those on the side. That's awesome. We have two more packs to open. We have a Jace pack. Check it out. That's so cool. Thank you guys for sticking with me. Obviously, I don't know that you're watching this right now, but because I'm filming it without anyone here, but still, thank you guys for the support. I really appreciate it. Here's the Liliana pack. We have two more packs to go, this one and one other. I doubt we'll get a second one, but it is definitely not outside the realm of possibility. Here's an Enshrouding Mist, a Weight of the Underworld, and a Crowan Sergeant, a Charging Griffin, a Might of the Masses, a Water Courser, a Ringwarden Owl, a Mantle of Webs, Boggart Brute, Alchemist's Vial, a Whirler Rogue is our first uncommon, Totem Guide Heartbeast is our second, and Blightcaster with that sweet art is the third. Our rare or mythic behind that is a Willbreaker. I almost laughed hysterically seeing the blue. It is just a Willbreaker. But still, it's a Willbreaker. Behind the Willbreaker is a Plains and an Angel token. Last pack with our boy on it, fingers crossed, because it's, like I said, not outside the realm of possibility to get a second one. So there's that. It is a Kytheon / Gideon pack on the inside. Let's see what is waiting for us within. From this Kytheon / Gideon pack, we have a card with Kytheon or Gideon on it, Grasp of the Hieromancer. I think at this point it was still Kytheon. Touch of Moonglove, Hitchclaw Recluse, Negate, Fairy Miscreant. We have a Llanowar Empath, Kytheon's Tactics, Gearpour Gearcrafter, one of our Kaladeshi friends. We have an Undead Servant, one of Liliana's friends. We have a Dreadwaters, Patron of the Valiant, which is a beautiful piece of art, uncommon or not, like just looks really cool. Scab Goliath, and a Ram Roller. And our last rare or mythic in this opening is Orbs of Warding. Looks cool, can't really say much more for it, but there's an Orbs of Warding. Behind that, anything else? Nope, we got a Swamp, and we got an Add card. I'll go through some stuff. Let's go through some stuff, shall we? We got two foils. We got the cool-looking Yiva's Force Mage in foil, and we got the okay-looking Stalwart Aven in foil. We got an Abbot of Carol Keep, which I was really happy about in the beginning. It kind of now doesn't matter as much. Behind that, we also got this Mythic in Avaricious Dragon. But, guys, this is the Hunt for Jace series, which has only had to go two episodes. Because, check it out. Look at that. He's right there. And he flips, and then he's right there, too. That's really cool. I don't know what else to say about it. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been absolutely fantastic. It went a lot better than I expected, and we finally got our Jace, however many months later and too late and whatever. But hey, like I said, Frontier's kicking off. It's kind of nice to have this guy if he continues to go up. If Frontier doesn't end up being a thing, well, then that's fine. I still have a Jace, and he's a good card regardless. So there you go. Thank you guys so much for watching. This has been the Geek for All YouTube channel. I've been Joe. Please let me know what you thought of this video in the comments down below. Give it a like or a dislike and give us your feedback. I don't know that this series is going to continue because we've reached our goal, but if you guys really want to see it, let me know and I'll see what else I can do. But otherwise, stay tuned for more content on our channel, obviously. This is not going to be the last video by any means. We have other things to open. So we will see you guys all soon, so you can subscribe to find out when more videos come out on this channel. And as we always say, in whichever video of ours you watch next, we will see you all next time. Thanks so much, everybody.